Sending emails is important. Sending emails timely is more important. But most important of all is sending relevant emails at the perfect time. And that's where email automation comes in. With email automation, you can handle your email campaigns even when you are asleep. Before we begin the email automation journey with FluentCRM, let's introduce you to the four major elements of FluentCRM's automation funnel. Trigger. It will start an automation funnel. Consider triggers as an event that happens on your website. For example, your users might submit a form, purchase a product, join a course, and do so many other things on your website. Triggers will let you capture these events so that you can start an automation funnel. To begin your automation, you must choose a trigger based on your needs. Let's say someone submit a form, you should select the form submission trigger to create automation based on that. Action. It will automate an action. Once an automation funnel has started, it is time to add actions that will do time-consuming automated operations on your behalf. Plenty of automation actions are available in FluentCRM, such as send emails, set email sequences, create WordPress user, add user to a course, etc. You can add these to an automation and let them run even when you are not present. For example, if you want to create a new WordPress user who submitted a form on your website, you can use the create WordPress user action to do so. Goal. It allows you to jump leads to right stage of a funnel. Goals can help you in two ways. You can send the audience to the right stage of the funnel, or you can keep contacts on hold if they didn't qualify for your next action. FluentCRM offers 8 such goals based on which you can automate a user journey. Let's say you want a subscriber to make a purchase after a few sales emails you've sent, and then send a thank you email for their purchase. In this case, your customer's goal is to make a purchase. Only then they will be qualified for the thank you emails. An order received goal can help you achieve this. Goals can be optional or essential. Now, if you select essential, then the next actions will continue only if the user meets this goal. And if you choose optional, it will work as an optional trigger. Condition. You can create yes-no paths based on your set condition. In some situations, customers might end up at a point where they make different decisions. The conditional blocks will let you create different paths so that you can dictate their journey and keep them in the loop no matter what they decide to do. Say you want to check if your contact is an American or not conditionally. If the contact is in the US, it'll result as yes. Otherwise, the answer will be no. Therefore, both yes and no will have two branches. Now, depending on your preferences, you can put various action blocks here. Well, guys, that was a brief explanation of FluentCRM's automation elements. Wait a minute. What about tracking the results of your automation funnels? Go to the automation dashboard and click reports of the funnel you want to see. You'll get to see more than just the data collected for automation. Simply select the report type you want to view. It can be a chart report, step report, or email analytics. Also, individual reporting is available. Analyze the report and take the right steps depending on your findings. Well, that's all for today. Start using FluentCRM automations to get better sleep at night and focus throughout the day. There's still a lot to learn, so stay tuned to WPManageNinja.